Hi, my name is Caleb for CellScale. I get asked sometimes about what kind of testing can be done for biological materials in an educational setting. So I thought I'd take today and demonstrate what can be done using our new UniVert product, which is a portable system that will be very suitable for educational use. What I'm going to be working with today is some specimens, most of from taken from chicken wings. I'm going to do some bending tests on the radius of a chicken wing, and we'll also do some tension tests using the skin from a chicken wing. These are things that are just readily available from a grocery store. I thought they'd be an easy thing to demonstrate on, and just to show the capabilities of the system and the software. To start with, I'm going to open a new test from a template. I've previously created a template for the chicken skin, where I've stored all the test parameters that I want to run. In this case, I'm going to run with a 20 millimeter initial grip separation, and I'm going to run 25% strain. The first thing I'm going to do is put the strip of skin in the fixed lower jaw. So I'm just reaching over here, opening up that spring-loaded jaw, and putting the skin in between that jaw. And the next thing I'll do is open up the upper jaw, put the skin in between the jaw, and allow it to close with the specimen placed between the jaws. Once that's done, I just simply have to go over to the software and click the run button. You'll see here on the right side of the screen the force versus time, the displacement versus time, and the force versus displacement curves. Next, I'll just run the next test. So I'm going to take out the first specimen from between the jaws, and then I'll take the second specimen and load it similar to the first. You'll notice when looking at the test data that it does appear just a little bit choppy. That's because the peak forces are about 3 newtons for this test, and I happen to have a 100 newton load cell in the system. We would have been better suited in hindsight to use a 10 newton load cell if this was primarily the type of testing that we were doing. And that test specimen actually was fairly similar to the first in terms of its mechanical properties. And we'll just test one more. We'll test 3 specimens of both the skin and the bone just to get a sense of just how similar each specimen is. And there's the last specimen mounted. Let's run that test. And it's also similar to the first two. Before we move on to testing the bone, let's take a look at some of the images we've gathered from those tests. Let's go into the Analyze and Review module of the software. I'm going to open up one of the tests and just play back the video and a few times just to observe what's happening. While the system's being used, this is a great feature to be able to do image analysis. There's a separate part of the software here where we can track the deformations of the specimen itself to get really accurate strain values. Also just qualitatively looking at what's happened to the specimen and where it's failed. The next thing I'm going to do is to remove the grips that are used for tension testing and install the jig that's used for doing 3-point bending test, which is the type of testing we're going to do on the radius bone of the chicken wing. Just remove this one bolt and install the lower part of the fixture. And I'll just tighten that up, put the specimen back on top, or put the system back on top of the base, and then I'll loosen off the upper grip and thread on the upper part of the 3-point bend jig. Once we have that set up, we're all ready to begin our testing with the 3-point bending. And this is going to go very similar to the tension testing, where we're going to start a new test from a template, a previously established template, and except it's a bone testing template, so it's going to be in compression mode rather than tension. And when we look at the software, it looks basically the same. We're going to do a downward motion in compression. And we've specified the amount, and I'm just backing off the jig here now so I can put the first radius bone in place. I'm just setting it here on the jig. And then the next thing I'm going to do is use the jog feature of the software to jog the actuator down until the jig just comes in contact with the bone. And then I'm going to start the test protocol. Here again, you see the live force versus time and displacement versus time and force versus displacement data. And it's very obvious where the bone cracks and failed. Let's get on with the second test then, exactly the same as the first test, where we're going to first start the test and jog the jig back open again so I can remove the first bone, and then put in the second bone and jog it back down before starting the test. And there we go, and we're starting the test. And we see very similar characteristics on that bone. So again, I'll start another test so that I have the live window, which will enable me to jog the actuator back up again and put in the third radius bone. As you can tell, I've accelerated some of these timelines just to make this video a little shorter. I'm not really quite that fast. So here we go with the third test, jogging it down manually and then starting the test. I hope you found this video interesting and helpful in understanding the system, the UniVert system, and how it could be used in an educational setting. If you're interested in more information, please contact CellScale. We'd be happy to talk to you about what your needs are, what we have available, and answer any questions you might have. Thanks.